under this part of our discussion on National Education Policy 1968, we shall discuss about the first paragraph, you can also say first aspect, second aspect, and the third aspect. We have already discussed that there are 17 aspects incorporated in New Education Policy 1968. And the first one is free and compulsory education. Second one is status, emoluments, and education of teachers. And the third one is development of languages. So not only New Education Policy 2020, but also New Education Policy 1968 talks in length about the development of languages of India. We shall discuss. But the first, that is free and compulsory education, will be taken care of. It was one of the commitment of the National Education Policy 1960. And the text, the New Education Policy, the content of the New Education Policy talks of the Article 45. Article 45 of Indian Constitution, before the enforcement of right to education in 2010, we were adopting Article 45 under directive principle of a state, and it was committed by the directive principle under Article 45 that free and compulsory education will be given to the children from the age of 6 years to 14 years. And so the National Education Policy 1968 also committed in the same manner, and it has also quoted in its text the Article 45, and it was felt that the major hurdle in the free and compulsory education is wastage and stagnation. So the National Education Policy also committed to reduce the wastage and stagnation in primary education, to provide compulsory education to all the students up to the age of 6 to 14 years of age. The policy clearly accepts the importance of teacher for the development of the nation and the education system of the nation. And so it recommended, it thought that without taking care of the education of the teacher, his status in the society, and his emoluments, it is difficult to streamline the education system in the country. And so, with due length, the National Education Policy 1968 talked about the status, emoluments, and education of the teachers. And it accepted that the teacher's personal qualities, character, decides the fate of all educational endeavors, that is quality of education, national development. And so the teachers must be given honor, good emoluments, better service condition, better education of teacher, मतलब टीचर्स मस्ट बी एजुकेटेड इन ए बेल मैनर सो दैट टीचर बीइंग द इनपुट इंपॉर्टेंट इनपुट ऑफ द एजुकेशन सिस्टम कुड कंट्रीब्यूट मोर टू द सिस्टम एंड इट वॉज डिसाइडेड दैट द टीचर मस्ट हैव बेटर क्वालिफिकेशंस एंड ही और सी मस्ट बी इंटरेस्टेड विथ द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज टू डेवलप द एजुकेशन सिस्टम एंड सब्सिक्वेंटली टू द कंट्री इट वॉज ऑल्सो डिसाइडेड दैट द एकेडमिक फ्रीडम टू द टीचर्स बी गिवेन एकेडमिक फ्रीडम बी गिवेन टू द टीचर्स सो दैट दे कुड राइट पब्लिश एंड स्पीक फॉर द बेनिफिट ऑफ द नेशन एंड ऑल्सो बिसाइड्स द नेशनल इशूज दे शुड टॉक ऑन द इंटरनेशनल इशूज इट वॉज ऑल्सो टॉक्ड इन द टेक्स्ट दैट द एजुकेशन ऑफ द टीचर दैट इज टीचर एजुकेशन मस्ट बी इम्फेसाइज एंड नॉट ओनली प्री सर्विस एजुकेशन स्पेशली द इन सर्विस एजुकेशन ऑफ टीचर इज मोर इंपॉर्टेंट सो फॉर टीचर्स द एजुकेशन मस्ट बी ए कंटिन्यूअस प्रोसेस वॉट सो एवर सब्सिक्वेंट इंप्रूवमेंट इन द फील्ड ऑफ नॉलेज इन द फील्ड ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी इज टेकिंग प्लेस द टीचर मस्ट adopt and acquire them through emphasis on his education and especially in service education. As we have already told that the new education policy 1968 like the national education policy 2020 also talks in detail about the language policy. And if you will compare the recommendation of both these national education policy, you will come to know so many aspects from this policy, that is 1968, has been taken in the policy 2020 as well. First aspect under the development of language was for the regional language. You can also say Indian languages. And it was decided that regional languages need to be used as medium of education even at university stage. For school primary or secondary stage, it is already recommended. But it was also suggested that for university level education, also the regional languages, and one also additional word was used, that is the Indian languages be used. So, kaha ki not only for प्राइमरी एंड सेकेंडरी एजुकेशन फॉर हायर एजुकेशन वो जो स्थानीय भाषा है भारतीय भाषा जो है रीजनल लैंग्वेजेस हैं उसका यूज होना चाहिए सो दैट वी कुड डेवलप आवर कल्चरल हारमोनी एंड नेशनल इंटीग्रेशन मतलब इन्होंने कहा कि रीजनल लैंग्वेजेस की मदद से हम लोग अब न केवल पढ़ाई लिखाई की बात करेंगे बल्कि कल्चरल हारमोनी और नेशनल इंटीग्रेशन का भी केयर ऑफ करेंगे और इट वॉज नॉट टॉक्ड इन टर्म्स ऑफ रीजनल लैंग्वेजेस ओनली द रीजनल लिटरेचर वॉज ऑल्सो सजेस्टेड टू एग्जॉस्ट सो अंडर द लैंग्वेज पॉलिसी द नेशनल एजुकेशन पॉलिसी 1968 talks about the regional languages, Indian languages, and regional and Indian literature as well. it also suggested three language formula. And what is three language formula? Three language formula include modern Indian languages, and of course there are, for language issue, there are two parts of the country. One is southern and other is northern New Kanchi. So it was suggested for the South India, for the southern part of the country, the language, three language formula, three language policy be English and Hindi besides southern language. Sorry. For North India, it was suggested, Northern India, it was suggested besides Hindi and English, the learners, the students must learn one South Indian language. Kannada hai, Malayalam hai, you must be knowing. And for this part, Hindi, English and regional language. इन नॉन हिंदी स्पीकिंग, मतलब हिंदी स्पीकिंग क्षेत्र के लिए हिंदी इंग्लिश के अलावा एक साउथ इंडियन लैंग्वेज, और साउथ इंडियन के लिए हिंदी इंग्लिश के अलावा, क्योंकि हिंदी उधर नहीं है, तो एक रीजनल लैंग्वेज, हिंदी इंग्लिश नॉन हिंदी स्पीकिंग स्टेट्स के लिए और हिंदी स्पीकिंग स्टेट्स के लिए, हिंदी स्पीकिंग स्टेट्स के लिए हिंदी English and South Indian language, और non Hindi के लिए एक regional language Hindi and English. ये three language formula अभी भी चला आ रहा है. New Education Policy 2020 also talks about it. It also, under the language formula, it also talks of the development of the propagation of Hindi. And it also quotes Article 351 of the Indian Constitution, which is about the expansion of Hindi languages in the country. And the text itself suggests, the policy itself suggests, to promote Hindi to develop as link language, encouragement for Hindi in non-Hindi states. तो ये कि हिंदी, नॉन हिंदी स्टेट्स में हिंदी को प्रोपिगेट करना, और चूंकि राष्ट्र की लिंक भाषा के रूप में हिंदी चूंकि सबसे ज्यादा लोगों द्वारा बोली जाती है, तो इसको लिंक लैंग्वेज के रूप में, ताकि दूसरी भाषा से हम दूसरी भाषा में बात करें तो बीच की भाषा जो हमारी हो हिंदी, इस टर्म में भी बात की गई. इट ऑल्सो टॉक्स अबाउट संस्कृत एज क्लासिकल लैंग्वेज, संस्कृत को क्लासिकल लैंग्वेज मानते हैं, इसका भी बहुत कंट्रीब्यूशन, इट्स डेवलपमेंट ड्यू टू इट्स कंट्रीब्यूशन इन द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ इंडियन लैंग्वेजेस एंड इंडियन कल्चर. पॉलिसी एक्सेप्ट द फैक्ट दैट इन द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ डिफरेंट इंडियन लैंग्वेजेस एंड द इंडियन कल्चर, द संस्कृत हैज ए वेरी ग्लोरियस रोल, एंड सो इट मस्ट बी glorified, it must be spread, it must be taken care of. Development of new methods of teaching language. अब इसमें संस्कृत टीचिंग के लिए मुख्य रूप से बाकी अन्य चीजों के बारे में भी the policy recommends, the policy suggests to work on the different methods and approaches that is instrumental for the teaching of संस्कृत एंड अदर लैंग्वेजेस. वर्क ऑन एक्सप्लोरेशन ऑफ द लैंग्वेज टू इंक्लूड इन द कोर्सेज ऑफ मॉडर्न इंडियन लैंग्वेजेस, मतलब वहां सजेस्ट किया कि थ्री लैंग्वेज में एक मॉडर्न इंडियन लैंग्वेज हो, तो ये कहा जा रहा है कि उस रूप में भी संस्कृत को लिया जा सकता है. सो संस्कृत कैन बी यूज्ड as a language for the development of modern Indian language. It can be read in ancient Indian history Indology, Indian philosophy. It means the policy suggests that Sanskrit can be learned, Sanskrit can be taught in the courses of modern Indian language, in the courses of ancient Indian history, in the courses of Indology, in the courses of Indian philosophy. As we have already told that the National Education Policy 1968 talks with due length about the language, and besides regional language, Hindi, Sanskrit, it also talks about the international languages. And of course, it accepts the utility of English as a language and other international languages as well. And a special emphasis on English and in other Indian languages be given so that we could connect to the world, whatsoever happening in the world, we could know by knowing the English as an international language, the other international languages, and we can also make the other part of the world aware about our development, whether it is in the field of Ayurveda, whether it is in the field of history, whether it in the field of ideology and many more. मतलब ये कि हम विश्व को जाने इंटरनेशनल लैंग्वेज की मदद से, और इस इंटरनेशनल लैंग्वेज की मदद से विश्व को हम यह जानने दें कि हमारा डेवलपमेंट क्या है, हमारा कल्चर क्या है. सो डेवलपमेंट ऑफ इंटरनेशनल लैंग्वेज और स्पेशली इंग्लिश मस्ट बी टेकन केयर ऑफ. सो यू कैन सी इन दिस पार्ट ऑफ आवर लेक्चर ऑन नेशनल एजुकेशन पॉलिसी 1968, we have talked of free and compulsory education, teacher as an important, the most important aspect the policy also accepts, his status, emoluments, education, etc., and the development of language, in which we talked about the regional language and its development, three language formula for South India, for North India, Hindi development, Sanskrit development, and learning and development of international linked languages. So this is all about this part of lecture. Thank you very much.